Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 6, and text number 1. Creation of the Universal Form. Rishi Ruvacha Ititasam Swashvaktinam Satinam Asmetyasaha Prasupta Lokatantranam Nishamya Gatim Ishvaraha. Translation and purport by His Loving Divine Grace. A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. The Rishi Maitreya said, the Lord thus heard about the suspension of the progressive creative functions of the universe due to the non-combination of his potencies, such as the Mahatattva. There is nothing wanting in a creation of the Lord. All the potencies are there in a dormant state. But unless they are combined by the will of the Lord, nothing can progress. The suspended progressive work of creation can only be revived by the direction of the Lord. Ichchanurupayasya, as explained in Brahma Samhita, as per the desire of the Lord, things starts moving in this world. So here, Maitreya Rishi is explaining that the creative function of the universe was in dormant state because till this time, Lord has not glanced on that. As he glances on this Mahatattva, then all the potencies, they become activated. In the next verse, it is explained there is a Lord's potency which actually provokes and gets them the things in the material universe. And here it is explained, Kala sadnyam tada devim bibracha shaktim vurukramaha travayim masti trayovim shati tatvanam ganam yukta avishata. The Supreme Powerful Lord then simultaneously entered into the 23 elements with the goddess Kali, his external energy, who alone amalgamates all the different elements. The Supreme Powerful Lord then simultaneously entered into 23 elements with the goddess Kali. The Mahatattva is constituted of 23 elements. And already in previous chapter, we have discussed about it. What are those? It starts with the material energy, total material energy, which is like a false ego, sound, touch, form, taste, smell. These are panch tanmatras. Then pancha mahabhutas, like earth, water, air, sky. Then five ganendriyas, eyes, ear, nose, tongue, and skin. And then five karmendriyas, hand, leg, evacuating organ, genital, speech. And then subtle senses also, like a speech, mind, and in the beginning we have seen the false ego. See, this all together, they becomes 23. Everything in this material world is combination of all these 23 elements, which is called as altogether or amalgamated way, they are called as a Mahatattva. All are combined together by the influence of time and are again dissolved in the course of a time. And that's why further in this same canto only, Lord has explained that karmana daiva netrena jantur deha prapadyate iti pumsa pretakana ashraya. The living entity, as per the karma and activity that he has done in his previous life, in the result of that, the material nature, daiva, gives him a particular body, which is none other than the combination of all these 23 elements. And it is run by time, kala. Kala. He operates everything actually. He is the cause of its appearance or srijan, creation, and he is the cause of destruction. And that's why it is said that all are combined together by the influence of time and are again dissolved in the course of a time. Time, therefore, is the energy of the Lord and acts in her own way by the direction of the Lord. This energy is called Kali and is represented by the dark, destructive goddess, generally worshipped by the person influenced by the mode of darkness or ignorance in material existence. In the Vedic hymns, this process is described as Mula Prakritir Avikritir Mahadadhyaha Prakriti Vikritayaha Sapta Soda Shakastu Vikaro Na Prakritir Na Vikritir Purushaha. The energy which acts as a material nature in combination of 23 ingredients is not the final source of creation. The Lord enters into elements and applies his energy called Kali. In all other Vedic scriptures, the same principle is accepted. In Brahma Samhita, 5th chapter, 35th verse, it is stated, Ekaupyasau rachayitum jagadanda kotim yachaktirasti jagadanda chayayadantaha andantarasta paramanu chayantarastam govindamadi purusham tamaham hajami. I worship the primeval Lord, Govinda, who is the original personality of a Godhead. By his partial planary expansion, that is Mahavishnu, he enters into material nature and then into each and every universe as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and then as a Kshirodakshaya Vishnu into all the elements, including every atom of matter. Such a manifestation of a cosmic creation are innumerable, both in the universes and in the individual atoms. So here the exact function and the activities of Lord's external energy, Kali, has explained. It said that Eko Apyo Asau Rachayitum Jagadanda Koti. In the form of Mahavishnu, millions and millions of Brahmandas, Anda Koti, they come out of his pores. Then what happens? Yat Shakti Rasti Jagadanda Chaya Yadanta. Then he himself enters in that universes as गर्भदक्षाय विष्णु, देन अंडांतरस्थ परमाणु चयांतरस्थम, देन इन हिज नेक्स्ट एक्सपांशन एज अ क्षीरोदक्षाय विष्णु ही enters in each and every atom and molecule of elements. And then everything starts working. So the consciousness that is given by the Lord himself. Otherwise this mat-tattva is just matter. It's of no use. Then further Prabhupada explains that this whole thing is explained in different scriptures also. It's not only in the Srimad Bhagavatam, but in all other scriptures also, the creation part has explained in this way. Especially the Brahma Samhita, which is the base for the Gaudiya Siddhanta. It gives the whole philosophy that how the whole creation has take place and how Brahma is as a second creator is functioning in this material universe. And how he is praying to the Lordship, because Lord is the cause of all causes for the creation of this cosmic manifestation. Then further Prabhupada, he explains and he quotes from Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter 42nd verse. Atva bahunaitena kim ज्ञातेन तव अर्जुन विश्वभ्याहम इदम कृष्णम एकांशिण स्थितो जगत. ओ अर्जुन, देर इज नो नेसेसिटी ऑफ यूर नोइंग अबाउट माई इन्यूमरेबल एनर्जीज विच एक्ट इन वेरियस वेज. आई एंटर इन टू द मटेरियल क्रिएशन बाय माई पार्शल प्लेनरी एक्सपांशन, दैट इज परमात्मा और द सुपर सोल. In all the universes and in all the elements thereof. And thus the work of creation goes on. The wonderful activities of material nature are due to Lord Krishna. And thus he is the final cause of the ultimate cause of causes. See, again Prabhupada is making it clear. Someone may think that the above words, it explained that from Mahavishnu the Brahmandas are coming out. So he may be the cause of everything. But it's not. Because the verse starts with Eko api asau rachayitum jagadanda koti. That one from which innumerable universes comes out. But who is he? Yat Shakti. He is the potency of someone. And to support that statement by Brahmaji, Prabhupada has quoted from Bhagavad Gita, what Lord says. What he says? Vishtabhyaham idam krishnam ekamshana stito jagat. He said, Arjuna, try to understand that this whole material universe, it's just nothing but expansion of my energy. And he is telling Arjuna, because for you it's not necessary to know all the intricacies and functions of my different energies, because Arjuna is devotee. And that's why this knowledge has given to Arjuna, because he knows Krishna is the Supreme Personality of the Godhead. And the person once knows the topmost personality, then no need to find it out in detail who is who and where is what. Because all other things are done to find out who is on the top and what is his connection, and they can approach him. But if someone knows the boss directly, for him does not know to go to peon or go to the clerk or go to the finance or department or HR. If he has something to do, he will directly go to the boss and get it done. So same way, once one has taken shelter at the lotus feet of the Lord, for that person no need to waste his time on cultivating of knowledge. Cultivation of knowledge is meant for the people who are interested in jnana, knowledge, who wants to be jnana yogi, or impersonalist, who has more interest in becoming one with the Lord. But for devotees, knowledge a secondary thing that comes when they start rendering service to the Lord, then that is automatically comes along with that. Now there are bumper sales because of some festivals. So you buy one and you get two or get three. So same way, when you render devotional service, automatically two things you get freely. That is Gyan and Vairagya. And that's why Lord says here that Athava Bahunaitena Kim Nyatena Tavarjuna. Why there is a need to you that you should know about other energies of mine? Because you know me, the source of all energies. As our devotee, he took other meaning of that. That, oh, Lord has said no need of understanding these energies. But for whom? That we have to understand. For us, it's needed. Because we don't know Lord directly. Neither we are keenly interested and engaged in the devotional service. For us to know the supremacy of the Lord, we should know His energies and how they are working. Because still we don't believe that Lord is the cause of all causes. Unless and until you have that understanding that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of a Godhead, and through His will and strength, everything is working in this material world. To reach that knowledge, you need to understand all this. And that's why they are explained here in conversation between Vidura and Maitreya. Otherwise, before explaining, now as we go further after this creation, when the story starts from Srimad Bhagavatam, in the first story or first Upakhyan only, Kapila Muni has explained the details of individual creation, how the human being comes and what is his destination, what is his duty, what are the things that he has to do once he gets the human form of a life. Unless and until you understand the supremacy of the Lord, the creative energy, how it functions in this material world, it will be difficult to understand us how Lord is the Supreme. So the next verse, so anupravishto bhagavan te cheshtarupe natam ganam bhinnam samyo Jayam asa suptam karma prabodhayan. Thus, when the personality of a Godhead entered into the elements by his energy, all the living entities were enlivened into different activities. Just as one is engaged in his work after awakening from sleep. So now, what happens exactly when Lord glances upon this material elements? That has explained. Because of a destruction or pralaya, everything enters into Mahatattva and goes back into the Lord body. And when the Srishti happens, the creation takes place, from the Mahavishnu's body comes the different universes. Then each universes, he expands himself in the form of a Garbhodakshay Vishnu. Then Brahmaji comes to that particular universe. Then he creates all the things. Like an engineer, he collects all the raw materials and he builds a building. And unless and until someone purchases and possesses that and start operating that, it will not operate. It will be like that only, like a skeleton. So same way, when Lord enters, Brahmaji, he creates all the different species of life, bodies, everything. But unless and until the Jiva enters into that, and when Jiva enters into that, when Lord glances upon that. And that has explained here. Every individual soul remains unconscious after the dissolution of the creation and thus enters into the Lord with his material energy. The individual living entities are conditioned souls everlasting. But in each and every material creation, they are given a chance to liberate themselves and become free soul. If you are heard carefully, from the chapter 4th of 2nd Canto, this statement is again and again and again repeated by Prabhupada in his purports, that every material creation, the conditioned living entities are given a chance to liberate themselves and become free souls. The purpose of creation, again, again, and again, repeatedly, Prabhupada has mentioned, because the sole purpose of creation, we need to understand, that to get rid of this material world. As we have discussed in previous chapter, I think in couple of last verses, in one of the purports, Prabhupada says there are three causes. Understanding of a living entity, that there are three different causes. They think that material creation, one is meant for the enjoyment of the conditioned living entities. It's in the 5th chapter, last verse only. The Lord creates this material world and impregnates the material energy with the living entities who will act in the material world. All these actions have a divine plan behind them. The plan is to give conditioned souls who desire a chance to enjoy sense gratification. But there is another plan behind the creation. To help the living entities realize that they are created for the transcendental sense gratification of the Lord and not for their individual sense gratification. This is the constitutional position of the living entities. The Lord is one without a second, and he expands himself into many for his transcendental pleasure. All the expansions, the Vishnu Tattvas, the Jiva Tattvas and Shakti Tattvas, are different offshoots from the same Supreme Lord. The Jiva Tattvas are separated expansions of the Vishnu Tattvas, and although they are potentially difference between them, they are all meant for the transcendental sense gratification of the Supreme Lord. Some of the Jivas, however, wanted to lord it over the material nature in imitation of the Lordship of the personality of a Godhead. So here we have to understand, the main purpose of this material creation is to utilize the chance given by the Lord to get out of this material world. And how one can get out? By engaging himself in the service of the Lord to gratify the senses of the Lord, not his own. And generally, people, they misunderstand this whole concept. They don't understand the real plan of the Lord, that why Lord has created this material universe. They think that it is for me, to give me a chance to gratify my senses. But we have to understand that this chance has given us not to gratify our senses, but to gratify the senses of the Lord. And for that only, this whole knowledge is discussed. See, unless and until you understand this, you will not understand the wonderful and amazing pastimes of the Lord. when this whole creation part has explained, then only you will find the different stories of Lord's different incarnations. Their wonderful pastime has explained. Generally, the professional reciters of Srimad Bhagavatam, what they do? They don't go in the details of this creation chapter. And because of that, misunderstanding has created in the world. You will find there are people who are baniyas, who are big, industrialists, who has money with them. Every year they conduct Bhagavatam Sapta. They sponsor, they spend crores of rupees from their pocket. And ultimately, what they are understanding? They call themselves as the devotees of Devi, devotees of some demigod. They are worshipable deities as that, not Krishna. Because the real essence is never discussed when they call their professional reciters. The professional reciter, he just jumps on the stories of the different incarnations of the Lord, but he never explains them that how Lord is supreme. That's most critical and technical part of Srimad Bhagavatam, which has explained in first three chapters, first three cantos actually. They jump over that and they directly go through the stories. I never heard any professional reciter speaking on a Queen Kunti's prayer even, or they are speaking on the Bhishma Deva Stuti. They directly jump either on 10th canto, few of them, if they really know about the holy name, they speak something about Ajamila's story. But mostly they jump on directly the 10th canto. And because of that, what happens? Mass of the people, they get a common understanding that these are mythological stories. They does not have existence. Because they don't understand what they are hearing about the person and whom they are hearing about, who is that person? And that has explained here in this first three cantos. That need to be understood. It's boring, but still you have to understand this. They are all given a chance to take advantage of a Vedic wisdom and find out that their relationship with the Supreme Lord, how they can be liberated, and what the ultimate profit is in such a liberation. By properly studying the Vedas, one becomes conscious of his position and thus takes to the transcendental devotional service of the Lord, and he gradually promoted to the spiritual sky. We desire to go back home, back to Godhead. But without understanding this philosophy, you will not go back. That's not possible. And Prabhupada clearly mentions here that this, he calls this particular conditioned souls who are everlastingly in this material world, they are all given a chance to take advantage of the Vedic wisdom. This Vedic knowledge is meant for all conditioned souls, irrespective of place, birth, nationality. It is meant for all conditioned souls, not only human beings, but everyone, all the 84 lakh species of life. It's meant for everyone, provided how much they can absorb and how much they desire to imbibe that knowledge depends upon their own individual capacities. But this Vedic wisdom is meant for everyone. Unless and until you know this, it is clearly mentioned here, it's not possible to go back home, back to God. In the initial stage, because of some emotional environment or because of some family problem, people, they come and take up Krishna consciousness. They start chanting. But purpose of their chanting is not to serve Krishna or to accept Krishna as a supreme personality of a Godhead, but to get relief from their so-called material miseries. But that's not the proper understanding to render service to the Lord. Something is better than nothing, so it's okay. But that's not the way to approach the Lord. As Lord says that Artho Arthati Jigyasu Jnani, they come and take up the worship of their Lordship. But who can attain their Lordship? A Jnani. The person who is in knowledge. And which knowledge? This Vedic wisdom. And Lord clearly says, among these four, for me, more important is the person who is in knowledge. Which sort of a knowledge? Knowledge about what is their relationship with the Supreme Lord and how they can be liberated and what the ultimate profit is in such a liberation. If someone knows about this, then he is in knowledge. Then further Prabhupada says, by properly studying the Vedas, one becomes conscious of his position and thus takes to the transcendental devotional service of the Lord and is gradually promoted to the spiritual sky. Again, it is said gradually. Why that gradually is there?
It tells us to be patient.
Because knowledge is not only way through which you can attain the Lord. Knowledge can take you up to a particular level. From there onward, it starts with your surrender. And surrender never happens like a push button. You push it and it happens. It takes time. Because we are in touch or in contact with the material nature. And each and every element has its own layer on our consciousness. You have to tear apart this one layer, then the second, then the third, then the fourth, then the fifth. And that happens gradually. And here it said, he will come to spiritual sky. But when he renders devotional service, Lord says he comes to me directly. But to attain that platform where you can start rendering devotional service, you need to have this knowledge. And that's why that knowledge has explained here in this first three cantos. Make some sense? Huh? It may be boring, but need to be heard and contemplated on this. Because this is what strengthens your faith. The faith which progresses and becomes nishtha. That's what needed. The individual soul in the material world engage in a different activities according to their past unfinished desires. Who knows that how many desires that we have? Do we know? How many lifetimes, how many births? Like Tukaram Maharaj, he says that eka eka yoni koti koti phera. He says in one species of a life, we take birth like 100 and millions of times. because of desires. Because we don't know how many desires we have. If possible, someone may count waves of the ocean, but to count the desires that we have in our heart, it's not that easy. It's not that possible. And Lord has made arrangement to fulfill all your desires. So unless and until all this material desire gets fulfilled, you're not going back home back to God. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say, even at the time of death, even if you get a desire to eat a rasgulla or gulab jamun, which has offered to the Lord, even that also becomes a barrier between you and Krishna. For that reason, we need to understand this whole philosophy. Otherwise, it's very tough. Actually, in the beginning, I was thinking it's so easy, you know. What do you have to do? You have to just chant. You have to eat nice prasadam that they offer every day, like minimum 13 items. Yesterday, we were only discussing. Here in USA, only devotees who are staying in the temple are having a fresh fruit. Morning and evening. I don't think so. Anyone outside, they are every day cooking morning and evening. Do they? You are staying here for 35 years. More than that, I think, because you are in London also. So, what is people? You may have money with you, but can you have a fresh food at least? No. Then just think about how many things are there in this world itself to allure our mind. Do you think it's very easy to go back home back to Godhead by coming over all these impediments? When I first read this Brihad Bhagavat Amrut, I was tossed actually. Because when Gopakumar, he starts his journey going back home back to Godhead, then everything that Sanatan Goswami Pada has explained, that how he goes up, and while going up, what are the different allurements are there for that jiva? See, you may be nispruha in this world. Nispruha means not having any attachment for the worldly sense gratification. There are three svargas. One is a bilva svarga, one is bhauma svarga, one is a divya svarga. One may come out of this Bhauma Svarga. Even this Bhauma Svarga, if you, like there are 9 islands, one of these islands, you will have all the facilities that we'll discuss in the 5th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, where people have a strength of 10,000 elephants. Can you imagine? They have a strong and sturdy bodies, no old age. Everything is readily available there. There are the rivers of mango juice. Everything is abundantly available. Gopakumar has passed through that. He went up. When he went upward, then Divya Svarga has explained. What is there? If you read Mahabharata and the wonderful descriptions about Nandan Kanan Garden, the garden of Indra, and the beauty and the facilities for the enjoyment that are available there. If you heard that by hearing, I was in Kurukshetra once. I took some boys to for some yatra, and there was a big sale for Gita Press Gorakhpur's books, and they were having Srimad Mahabharata only for like 200 or 300, and all 7 books, volumes actually. They are huge, like this pages, 1 lakh shlokas with the translation. I wanted to buy that, but I was not having money that time. But I had one boy with me who had quite enough money to spend. So how to make him buy this? So I just opened that book and find out one particular description from Virata Parva, And when he read that, he said, Prabhu, I wanted to buy it. I said, okay, go ahead. I was knowing that this guy is not going to read it, but let him buy it. And he bought the whole set just by reading one page of the description that the sense gratification has explained in that part. He got so much attracted, which was there on this earthly planet in one of the king's kingdom. Then just try to understand the sense gratification that is available there in the heavenly planets. How you can come out? Ramya Rama Mrudutanulataha. Maharaj Kulashekar explained, oh my Lord, I am not that much allured and attracted by the Ramya Rama Mrudutanulata, the beautiful damsels of, or denizen damsels of heavenly planets who have a very soft skin and attractive beauty. He said, I'm not interested in that. When he can say that, when his mind is totally captivated by the, what we sing every day in the evening now. Huh? Satyavrat Muni says, Varam deva moksham na moksha vadimba, na cha anyam vrinneham vareshadapiha. But what he wants then? What's the second line? Idam deva purnartha gopala balam sadame manasya vitam kimanni. I don't want any kind of sort of a liberation. What to speak of a sense gratification? Once my mind got attracted to the beautiful form of that small boy, beautiful form of yours, my Lord, then only it's possible. Otherwise, going there means forget, you're not going back. You're getting hooked up somewhere. And again, enjoy that and come back. But I think Dravida Prabhu that day was saying that Mahaprabhu, he appeared in this particular. He was saying about that. That Mahaprabhu, we are so lucky that he just appeared 500 years back. And we got such a wonderful chance, Bengali Dada, to go back home, back to Godhead. And if we slip out then. It's very essential to understand this. The rarest opportunity that we have got it. And if we lose it, that's why it is called that Manda Sumanda. This is what Sumanda. Sumanda means unfortunate. Someone, king has become happy and he asks you, okay, you ask anything. Today I'm happy, I will give you. You go and you ask him, I need a begging pot. This is what you are going to ask him. Here, Mahaprabhu himself has given the simplest way to attend the Lordship. And they chant the holy name of God. And we don't never pay attention for that. Lord, he himself has come and given, we are not accepting. Then who is going to save us? Is there anybody else? No way. So here, the individual soul in the material world engages in the different activities according to the past unfinished desire. After the dissolution of the particular body, the individual soul forgets everything. But the all-merciful Lord, who is situated in everyone's heart, as the witness, the super soul, awakens him and reminds him of his past desires. And thus he begins to act according in his next life. Now question may come or may arise in your heart that, okay, if really I have forgotten, then why Lord has to make us remember that this is what my desire? If he knows that is a bad desire, which is taking away me from Krishna, then why he is reminding me about that desire? Let me just forget. Why is not forcing me to desire something else that I can go near to him? Again, we have to understand that it is dormant stage. It's not that desires are totally eradicated. At any time in future, you may remember that desire and you may go back to your previous consciousness. So he says, okay, finish it off. Because as Lord says that Matta Smriti Jnanam Apohanam Cha, from me comes the remembrance and confusion also. So both things he gives. Okay, take it. This unseen guidance is described as a fate. So what is fate? Prabhupada has a given definition for that. The unseen guidance given by the Lord is known as a fate. And sensible man can understand that this continues his material bondage in the three modes of nature. The unconscious sleeping stage of the living entity just after the partial or total dissolution of the creation is wrongly accepted as a final stage of a life by the some less intelligent philosophers, like a charvaka. And they say there, Yavat jive sukam jive dranam kritva kritam pivet basmi bhutasya dehasya kim punaragman. They consider this body is finished, so everything is finished. No. Only these 23 elements, they are dissolved, not the consciousness. After the dissolution of the partial material body, the living entity remains unconscious for only a few months. And after the total dissolutions of the material creation, he remains unconscious for millions of years. But when the creation is again revived, he is awakened to his work by the Lord. The living entity is eternal and the wakeful state of his consciousness, manifested by activities, is his natural condition of life. He cannot stop acting while awake, and thus he acts according to his diverse desires. Who drives us? Our desires. When his desires are trained in transcendental service of the Lord, his life becomes perfect and he is promoted to the spiritual sky to enjoy eternal awakened life. The last and most important statement. When his desires are trained in the transcendental service of the Lord, his life becomes perfect. And he is promoted to the spiritual sky to enjoy eternal awakened life. And Prabhupada said, our temples are training institute where people can be trained in devotional service. As per your individual capacities, propensities you are born with, you are trained to engage in Krishna consciousness. And that's why Prabhupada has used very wonderful word, dovetail your propensities for the service of Krishna. That makes a lot of difference. So we'll stop here and wish you, all of you, happy Diwali. Maybe in the evening we'll discuss about why we celebrate Diwali. Okay. Yes.
What was the number of the last verse?
Today we discussed. Which last verse do you want?
The one you just ended.
Huh?
The one you just. Last one that you remember.
That is not from Bhagavatam. That was from somewhere else. That Charvak, his philosophy, the Charvak philosophy. That is from there. That was not from Bhagavad Gita or Bhagavatam. That one of the philosopher, he had his particular philosophy. That just enjoy. Who has seen? Once you are put into your coffin, you are not going to come back. So as long as you have life and this body, enjoy. Heart's content. For that you may beg, borrow, steal. But eat. What they leave, what they say? Be mad. What? One particular phrase is there also in English. I think London people, they mostly know. Beg, borrow, or steal, and something is further there. Something further is there. The same philosophy, that Charvaka preach, the British, they carried that philosophy to Europe rather than Bhagavad Gita. So Prabhupada came and gave them this, the proper, what you should carry from India as a knowledge. Even people, they don't know what to carry and how to carry. Srila Prabhupada ki.
सारा चीज को सृष्टि भगवान करते हैं तो फर्गर पुल में सब ज्ञान भी मुझे देते हैं तो फर्स्टली इन बिगिनिंग तो कोई कंडीशन तो है
मतलब कंडीशन
बिगिनिंग अवस्था में कोई भी जीव तो बद्धा तो नहीं है ना अगर बद्धा चाहे तो भगवान ही बद्धा निकाले ना जीव मेरे कहने का मतलब इन द बिगिनिंग बिगिनिंग लेस बोलते हैं फिर भी तो एक नित्य नित्यानंद चंदन एक विधा के नाम बोल रहे हैं एक बहुत होने का मन हो गया भगवान का यही है ना बात तो वही रहता है ना आइदर स्पिरिचुअल और मेंटल और मार्जिनल जो भी पोटेंशियल शक्ति जो भी है वे तो भगवान से निश्चित है भगवान से निकला हुआ है तो कंडीशन तो कोई भी नहीं है उस समय जब जब सृष्टि हुआ तब तो कोई कंडीशन नहीं जो प्रकृति है जीव हो या भगवान हो और ये सब चीज तो जो भगवान से निकल रहा है तो आध्यात्मिक हो या भौतिक तो उसका सृष्टा तो भगवान है सृष्टि करने वाला तो वही है तो उस समय कंडीशन जीत तो भगवान निकाले होंगे अगर तो नहीं तो कैसे कंडीशन होगा मतलब बद्ध अवस्था में कैसे रहेगा कि भगवान ही बद्ध कराना चाहते हैं ना नहीं तो बद्ध कैसे होगा
ओके
हाँ
मैं बोलूं
हाँ
नहीं ये एक्चुअली इसलिए बोला कि इन तीन स्कंदों को पढ़ना इसलिए आवश्यक है नहीं तो फिर ये कन्फ्यूजन क्रिएट हो जाता है कि फिर हम समझते हैं कि बद्धता तो है ही नहीं लेकिन है इसका यहाँ पे जब प्रभुपाद तात्पर्य में लिख रहे हैं अगर आपने प्रिसाइजली सुना होगा चाहे तो आप एक बार पढ़ लो इस तात्पर्य का प्रभुपाद बोलते कि एवरलास्टिंगली कंडीशन एवरलास्टिंगली कंडीशन मीन्स वॉट जो जीवात्मा है जैसे उस दिन हम ना आप 11वें स्कंद का एक श्लोक है उसमें बताते हैं कि अवजानंती तो जीवास हु और ऐसे कुछ जीव रहते हैं जो भगवान की भगवत्ता को मानते नहीं है
कब से नहीं मानते
वो तो ऊपर जाके पूछना पड़ेगा क्योंकि प्रभुपाद को भी एक ने ऐसे ही पूछा कि कब से हो रहा है बोले अभी उसके लिए डिस्कस मत कर अभी जो टाइम मिला है उसमें निकल जाए से और वहां अंदर उसके पास जाके सारा पूछ ले कि मैं कब गिरा
ये तो उत्तर नहीं हुआ ना
नहीं उत्तर नहीं है कि इस कहां तक जाओगे तो आपका लिमिटेशन से कि कितना तक गिन पाओगे मैं अगर बोल दिया कि 17 खरब वर्षों से आप यहाँ पे तो 17 खरब के उसके ऊपर कितने शून्य गिनने में आपके लाइफ चली जाएगी
नहीं ये तो बात तो बिगिनिंग ही कर रहे हैं ना
अगर शास्त्र ही अनंत बोलता है
तो इसका
मतलब ये नहीं कि फिर वापस वापस क्यों आओगे या अगर वही चीज रिपीट करोगे तो वापस आ जाओगे
सिंपल सा ही है तो कंडीशन कैसे होता है
कौन सा
कंडीशन कैसे होता है कंडीशन होने के लिए डिजायर आना पड़ेगा ना भगवान को नहीं मानने का डिजायर आना पड़ेगा वो डिजायर जो जीव में आता है वो उसके अंदर भी तो डिजायर देने वाले तो भगवान ही है
नहीं
क्यों नहीं है
नहीं क्योंकि वो स्वतंत्रता आपको दी है अगर भगवान चाहते तो किसी को यहाँ लाते ही
वो
नहीं।
स्वतंत्रता देने का मतलब भी तो भगवान देते हैं ना उसको,
हाँ
तो भगवान देने के मतलब उसके ऊपर भी जो आने वाला डिजायर है उसका भी तो प्रतिपादन भगवान कर रहे हैं ना, जो जीव उत्पन्न हो रहा है। तो हमारा जैसा ये एनालिटिक नहीं मिलता है भगवान के साथ, जैसे हम संसारिक जो चीज देते हैं ना, तुम्हारा पुत्र, तुम्हारा हम पुत्र हो तो भी हम अपना सोल नहीं ले पाते उसके, और सोल वापस ले भी नहीं पाते। अगर भगवान चाहे तो ये चीज कर सकते हैं उसमें, भगवान में तो ये महत्ता है ना, हमारा जैसे तो नहीं है।
अभी वो किसी की स्वतंत्रता में इंटरफेयर नहीं करना चाहते तो उसको क्या करें?
देने तो वही दिया,
उन्होंने दिया है तो उसमें इंटरफेयर नहीं करना चाहते। अभी वो फिर वही बता पाएंगे, मैं तो नहीं बता पाऊंगा, इसलिए वहां वापस जाना पड़ेगा। तो आओ प्रयास करते कि वही जा और उनसे पूछ ले कि भाई ये प्रॉब्लम है मेरा, कि मैं समझ नहीं पा रहा हूँ कि आप क्यों इतना,
इसलिए पूछ रहा हूँ कहीं से ऐसे
नहीं है, कहीं कहीं पे भी उसका रेफरेंस नहीं है। आप चाहे तो जैव धर्म तक पढ़ लो, जहाँ पे ये सारे डिस्कशंस किए भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर जी ने,
थोड़ा तो पढ़ा जाएगा,
पूरा पढ़ो तो मालूम पड़ेगा। वो अंत में यही बताते कि इस पे ज्यादा तर्क करके फायदा नहीं है, क्योंकि ये भगवान की इच्छा है और उनकी इच्छा क्या है जब तक हम भक्त नहीं बनते तब तक हम नहीं जान पाएंगे। तो उसके ऊपर कुछ टीका टिप्पणी करना या कुछ तर्क करते रहना इसमें
ये निकालने का आइडिया दिया है, ऐसे आप लोग निकलो इसमें तो ये है,
तो निकलो ना यहाँ से, निकलोगे तो भगवान बोल देते मैं तुमको ज्ञान दे देता हूँ जो तुमको मालूम पड़ जाएगा उससे।
निकलने के लिए तो दे रहे हैं,
ऐसे ही प्रभुपाद से ऐसे ही पूछ रहा था, अंत में प्रभुपाद बोले काम कर जो बताया उतना कर और वापस जाओ, उसको पूछ कि उसने भेजा है ना, मैंने तो नहीं भेजा, मैं सिर्फ ये बता रहा हूँ कि जाना कैसे उसके पास। अब तुम कब आए, मुझे क्या जान के फायदा उससे, क्योंकि शास्त्रों में कहीं भी वर्णन नहीं कि ये पर्टिकुलर टाइम है और जीव गिर गया करके,
नहीं मेरा तो मतलब क्या है,
क्योंकि वो बद्ध हो गया करके। बद्धता का लिमिटेशन ही नहीं है, क्योंकि इतने सारी इच्छाएं हमारी, तो फिर उनको ही जाके पूछेंगे तभी मालूम पड़ेगा कि वही एक सर्वज्ञ है, स्वराट भी है। वो स्वराट होने के कारण यू कांट क्वेश्चन एनीथिंग
एल्स, कोई भी भक्त ने अभी तक पूछ के दिया भी नहीं। इसमें जो वर्णन आते हैं कई सारे भक्त हैं, कई मिले हैं भगवान से, फिर भी तो
उनको जरूरत ही नहीं है ना, बोले गिर गया ना,
वो तो
जैसे लोग बोलते हैं ना
हिंदी लिए बात करते बोला, तो अभी तक ये प्रश्न नहीं किसी ने पूछा कि ये बद्ध हो गए निकलो तो बोल रहे हैं, सब लोग बोल रहे हैं, सब भक्त पूछ भी रहे हैं, यही चीज क्यों नहीं पूछ रहे, ये भी एक बात है। जो निकल गए ना, जो मुक्त हो गए, मुक्त आत्मा जो जो थे, जितने लोग यहाँ संसार का संसार से विरक्ति हो गए और जो भगवान के सारा आगे से देख लिया
क्यों एवरी ईयर वो डेट सेलिब्रेट करनी है क्या, एनिवर्सरी में गिरने की एनिवर्सरी करके इस दिन में मैं कंडीशन हो गया जैसे मैरिज एनिवर्सरी करते हैं, इस दिन में बन गया कर, क्योंकि उतना आवश्यक नहीं है वो, इसलिए नहीं पूछा। अगर उतना आवश्यक होता जानना तो कोई ना कोई तो पूछ लेता भाई, इतने सारे डिस्कशन हुए कोई एक तो पूछ लेता कि नहीं मालूम पड़े, चलो मैत्रेय जी आप बताओ कम से कम आप जानते
हो।
नहीं उसके लिए देखो आवश्यक, कितना वैदिक विजडम है हमारे पास, कितना अध्ययन करते हैं उसके ऊपर भी
नहीं पूछा।
इंडिविजुअल पर डिपेंड है।